363s. I tell all my hoes, break it up. Break it down. Bag it up. Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up. They say I'm a storm. VDS is in my chest. That's a rocker. Rake it up, rake it up, rake it up. Tell the nigga pay up, pay up. She said pay for the pussy, pay for the pussy. Hey, wait for the pussy, wait for the pussy. Ain't God to forgive me. Cause I pray for the pussy, pray for.
Hey people, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Ama Governor and today's video is on asking for a friend. I'm sure you guys know what that is from the very first video, and most of you guys asked for these same girls. These girls. My girls.
We're back.
And if you guys remember, I said that I could not answer all the questions from the very first asking for a friend video. So we're just going to answer the other questions, okay? So let's just start off this video. Well, I know you guys already know their names, but they have to introduce themselves again for the new subbies and the new viewers.
Look here. Hi, I'm Shadi.
Unfortunate.
So the very first question. My friend has always dated older guys, say 5 or 4 years older than her. Guys like that, aside being young or rich. But they've always ended up breaking her heart. Now she's with someone of her age. He treats her right and she's never been happier in any other relationship. She, however, cannot get over the last older guy she dated completely. Do you think that she just misses the expensive dates and gifts? Or getting over someone is a gradual process and hence would happen eventually?
What about the situation with me? If you've been attached to something for a while, you definitely miss it. So it's, I think it's normal to miss something. Maybe the gift, maybe the older guys. She will definitely miss this person. Take a while, but she'll get over it.
I don't think that it's necessarily the gift. You know, people who date older guys, some people are genuinely more attracted to older guys than younger guys. And that's fine, really. Especially 4 or 5 years older, like you said. And so I just think maybe they just really have a deeper connection, or that she's more attracted to, she's more used to dating older guys because, like you said, she's been doing that for a really long time. And now switching to like people of her age is just maybe not her style, so she needs time to adapt. I don't necessarily think that it's expensive gifts, although I wouldn't suspend that completely. It could be because of that.
So for me, I think since she's having a relationship, she's not, I don't think it's bad for her to probably miss what she was into before, because she was sharing something with the other older guy before. So obviously she has the right to miss her, but since she's having a relationship, I would advise she try not to show the fact that she's missing whatever she's missing the other relationship and stick to the present relationship and maintain it. Don't show that you're missing whatever you're missing in the other relationship.
But I would say that even if, like, okay, so if she's with this guy, right, but she's not like feeling the vibe, like she's not, I think she should just go back to dating older guys, because sometimes that's just the kind of people, you know, some people are attracted to specific types of people and they can't, like, it's difficult for them to switch. So okay, that's what I'm saying. So the next question, I like this guy and we spend a lot of time together. The thing is, I just got out of a relationship some months ago and I don't know if I'm ready for another relationship. What do I do?
You like the guy, right?
Yeah, she likes him.
If you like the guy, why should you wait? Like, I don't get why.
I'm just saying, if
you are not ready, if you know that you are not ready,
then give yourself
then
time.
Please, just give yourself a break, like rest. Because coming out from a particular relationship is a very big stress for you to enter.
Yeah, it's just so you are not aware that you are not ready.
Yeah,
so just call somebody to
be with you. That's true.
So you just have to be sure that you're ready for this. You don't want to go into a relationship to go and get somebody else.
because you may end up hurting the person. I would say, like, but I would, you know, I don't want you to block your blessings because this other guy could be like him.
Yeah.
But so I would say, like, you should talk to the other guy, let him know how you feel, like, let him know that you need time. If he's really down for you, like, he would wait. I mean, it would just because it's been months already, so maybe a couple more months, and then you are good to go. So he wouldn't have to stress so much, and he would just, you know, wait, and then when it's time and you're all ripened and healed, and you're healed, he'll come back. You bug. So the next question. So there's this friend who actually lied to this guy, and they were getting to the relationship height. But somehow, some way, things got messed up because the girl was doing stuff with other guys, but he was patient enough. Then the next moment, the same guys who told the guy that the girl had been doing things with other guy came to tell the girl that he tells other girls that he loves them. And apparently things just got ruined. Now the guy is saying to the girl that if they want to come together and be in a relationship, that's cool. If not, that's fine as well. But the guy wants to give up because the girl says that her feelings are off one time and that they are on one time just because of the things that she's been hearing about him. What should she do? I don't even know why she should be saying that her feelings are off one time. Like, she's the one who says that she likes him and then goes to do stuff with other guys. And then for this guy,
she's actually doing stuff with other guys.
Yeah.
Bitch, you're a big whore. Like, wait. You like this guy. Why are you still doing stuff with other guys? Like, he won't even have respect for you. Like,
this could not be physical. I'm not saying this could not be physical. Yeah. It could be spiritual. Anything.
Please forget the spiritual part of this. Let's talk about
reality. It's probably not your fault. All right. It's probably something back. Because if a pretty girl like you is actually in the right sense,
and we know you're pretty because all girls are pretty,
you wouldn't be doing stuff like that. So you should find out. You should go to your church and say, this is what is happening to me. Pray for me. You should pray because you don't know how.
This question is annoying me. Like, I'm actually very angry. But like, I don't want to pour out my full mind here. Because if I should pour it out, there'll be fire in this video.
When his friends came to tell him that you are doing stuff with other guys, he still came to you and told you that he wants to, he wants things to work out. So what I will say is, you know, you obviously have some issues. So, and that which is not a bad thing, because everybody has, we all have issues. So it's not a bad thing. But then if you really want, think about it, and just sit down and think about it. If you really want to be with this guy, you have to stop doing things with other guys. Sit down with him, you know, tell him that you want to do. So then obviously you shouldn't even bring this guy into your picture. Just work on yourself.
I believe that any girl that likes a boy, her full attention, her mind is on that boy. Like, I don't know.
It's not every girl.
You still want to do things with other boys, even if you're in love with someone.
Yes.
Challenge is not for me. I'm media. I think I'm different.
Yes.
Yeah. I would say just work on yourself.
Seen,
I know some people that do that.
Yeah. Work on yourself. You like, you obviously have issues.
From such a
it's just like that. That's why I'm saying there's just nothing like normal that. About it. Then it's spiritual. Because it's not understandable.
I feel like it's spiritual. You're correct.
Now you agree. Now she agrees.
If you're normal, like, you're in love with a guy, you are in love with
maybe
a
she's
guy.
Not in love, maybe she just likes him or it's just a crush.
Okay, if you like him, that one is different. But if you're really in love, she's like different. Because she doesn't like the guy, why is she complaining? Why is she seeking for advice?
But you know, some girls are just like jealous like that. Like, they just want, they're just selfish.
If you
they want this, but they want to have other things on the side.
If you really need my advice or my opinion, please. If this guy is still there, stop whatsoever you're doing to other guys. Because no matter what you're doing, let me tell you, no matter what you do in life, let me tell you, like, that's just simple truth. No matter whosoever you do shit with in this life, it will come back, like, one after the other, it will come back. Like, that your boyfriend, I'm telling you, that your boyfriend will hear of it one day, your husband will hear of it. God will punish you to be one of the boys that.
Everybody pray. The last
and the prayer, if you think, if you know that your is not staying quiet and you want to every time, every time, please pray. Pray about prayer helps in all these things. Read books. Go to, if you're in school, read your book. When you're reading your book, all
you
this
feel like
all this feel like
engage in extracurricular activities.
Everybody's body itches.
Go swimming,
them.
Do soccer, do table tennis, go golfing, like whatever, bro. Okay, let's just jump on to the next question. I think I'm catching feelings for this guy. We really talk a lot, like every day, and he hasn't said he likes me or anything. I visited him in his room one time and he wanted me to sleep over, but I said no and I left. But I don't know if the feeling is mutual or not. I don't want to assume and catch deep feelings. Sigh. I'm so confused.
Girl, I understand. Trust me.
Almost every girl goes through
this.
Yeah. That's true. It's actually true.
The question is, does the guy act as if he likes you?
Yeah, does he act?
Like, does he even show anything? Or is it just that, yeah, maybe guys can tell you. Some guys can tell you, oh, come and stay in my room. Come, let's talk to this. You get. But you... because you're catching feelings, you're like, oh, he told me to go to his room. Like, please.
Be sure.
Be sure.
Just
it's not when a guy.
Observe him.
Yes, please. Be in fact, ask him. Please,
you
go
don't
assume
anything.
I will advise you. Go straight to the point. Ask him.
But if you're bold, then ask.
Do you like me? Because. Bro, like, I like you. I don't know. No. Okay, I don't think I can do that, but I will advise.
Why can't you do that?
Yes, I'll advise someone to do that.
Why? No, I don't like stress, so I don't like stress at all. Like, Papa, do you like me?
I'm taking
you. Because obviously, I like you. If you're not
if
down,
you don't
go.
Like me, I'll take my way.
I'll just go. Because, like, you know, some guys really take a really long time. Like, I don't know, some guys, they really rush. Like, some guys are so, I don't know. Like, what do you think you are? What do you think you are?
Like, do you know some of them, man? They are so stupid that they know that you like them.
They know.
But these boys, they will never. Even if they like you, crap. So long as they know that you like them, they won't come and ask them out. Yeah, your mind is stupid.
Come
and ask you out. You have to. Boys are
like,
supposed to be the one doing the asking out now. So if you notice that this girl likes you, and yes, you know that this girl likes you, and you don't like her, just tell her that. Oh, just explain everything. So
because girls catch feelings.
Yes, girls catch feelings, and when they catch feelings like this, for it to go is very, very difficult. And even if it goes, the small particles will still be there. So I don't know.
But I'm really glad that you said you are not going to stay in his room, even though you like
that
you
means,
like
that means your that means she values her pride. Like she's.
Yeah, go girl, you guys.
This is how all girls should behave.
Yes,
not the one that one night if they invite you, go, thank you. Get out of the bed, let me lie down, make space.
So, the next question, okay, please. My friend is feeling lonely, she just came out of a relationship and wants to move on, but doesn't know how to because she's still attracted to the guy, and also he was the first person she had any sexual contact with. This sexual contact is not sex, but you should know what I mean. That's why she still has a connection with him. I know that people say that, like, there's this connection with the person you've had sexual contact with, and it's probably true, but, like, don't let that hold you back. I've heard of so many girls who stay with a guy because they've had sex with them or sexual encounters with them, and like even though the guy continually cheats on them, they still stay. Bro, you live only once.
So some girls can actually endure a lot, and it's not necessary.
But you know that people like feel generally lonely when they just come out of a relationship. Mm-hmm. So just give yourself
time.
Yeah, like, it's normal. It's normal to feel
lonely. Try to find something.
Yeah, your girls, you know, or if you're like someone who goes out a lot, like do whatever.
She's
like
not
it takes.
Goes out.
Yeah, so you're
just do something
okay,
you like, you're
she,
interested
yeah,
in.
So
yeah, go
like you were saying, what if you don't have girls? What if you don't like go out clubbing and all that? That's fine. Like, find something that you like.
You
something that
you
keeps
make
you
up for people.
Occupied. Yeah.
You just
you can you.
If you like going out
go
to
the
eat
gym,
out, go out. Yes,
sports,
go and work out.
Like, I don't know.
Socialize.
Read books.
Yeah.
Books.
Yeah.
So do things.
Yeah.
That, I don't know. Just.
But it's normal. Like basically, it's normal. It doesn't. And please don't like just take your mind off it. I feel like it's a mindset that once you've had sexual encounters with a person, you can't move on.
Yeah,
it's a mindset. Like
true.
Get. bro,
he's not even thinking about you.
And yes, like, look, he's not even thinking about
you. He probably is, though.
He probably is. He probably stalking you, but he probably is not as well.
Yeah.
So, like, leave your past in your past. But the next question. I have a girlfriend living in the US and I met her on social media. We both love each other and because of that I can't learn very well in school. I am always thinking of her and she also wants to hear from me every single day. I'm older than her too and since she came to my life, I have still been cheating a little bit on the side. Please, is there any way you can help me out?
He has been cheating
on the side.
First of all,
you know,
you, like, you really love the person.
It's long distance, anyway.
But Walsha, it's long distance.
What are you saying? Are you saying long distance relationship is like a platform where you cheat?
No, I'm not saying that.
But you're saying it's possible. Yeah, it's
more in long distance than
Yeah, that's understandable. So, my friend, listen, everybody, you have to know yourself. Some people can do long distance and stay faithful, like me. Like her.
Now. Mom is shaking. Yeah. Don't stand that. Please.
So, and some people can't, okay? So, if you know you can't, don't waste her time. Just like, tell her. Or you know what? Tell her that you're cheating, okay? And then see if she's willing to forgive you. And then first check if you are willing to change. Yeah. If you know you're willing to change, ask her to forgive you. And then, you know, if you were me, I wouldn't forgive you, though. Like, I would not forgive you, though.
Please,
but
I won't forgive you, never.
Some people
But, like, seriously, if you really like this girl, bro, please. Stop the nonsense you are doing.
Yes, stop.
It doesn't even make any sense. If you really love this girl and you know that you can't stop cheating and you know you really love this girl,
end
that relationship.
Yeah. Tell her.
Just stop the relationship. Tell her that you can't keep with it again.
Yeah.
Just start up something with wheresoever you are and stop deceiving yourself that, oh, I'll cheat tomorrow, I'll not cheat today, I'll cheat it tomorrow, I'll not cheat next week. Then when I go back to that place she is, I will continue. Please don't transfer disease to that innocent girl.
It could be that she's also doing this in Malaysia, she's not sending. I'll be now.
Yeah, it's true.
Well, it's true.
So you see, you're equally helping the girl by breaking up with her. So she gets someone from there too.
Okay, so the very next question.
People should give you
How do you know that your man is cheating and how is the best way to handle it?
When his phone is placed down, he's cheating.
When he stops eating your food,
he's cheating. When he calls you another girl's name, he's cheating.
When he stops calling you sweet words,
he's cheating.
He stops coming home early,
he's cheating.
When he has so many Instagram DMs,
he's cheating.
When he likes your friend's pictures on Instagram,
no.
Or when he's liking his girl's pictures on Instagram,
he's cheating.
When he quotes a girl's tweet with love.
He's cheating. The way he smells of another girl's perfume,
he's cheating. Yeah, he's
bad. He's not married.
Oh my god, you guys get used to your man's perfume. If I buy your man's perfume,
yes.
If anything should happen, why are you not smelling of active man? Why is he not active woman?
If you're really close to your man, like you guys actually have a connection, you know when he's cheating. Something will move. Something will change.
So
like,
what if you don't have a relation?
So I'm going very smart.
Let me tell you.
I know, but like,
number one, make sure you know. One, you should have a serious, like, when you're in a relationship, you should be so intimate with your boyfriend. Like,
not like should, physical intimate.
Yeah. You should know him. Know everything about
him. Like, connection.
You should know things he's already, things he does and things he doesn't do. And when he starts doing the things he doesn't do before,
you could tell.
Uh-huh.
You know, guys may be smart, but I don't think that they are always smart. Like, they are not always smart. There's small things that they
yes.
miss. There's small,
like,
small
actually,
things.
Yeah,
you can catch them.
Don't follow men with anger. Calm down. Act as if everything is fine. Baby, are you fine?
Set traps. I would say
even
set traps,
angry,
okay?
Try to kiss him the way you used to kiss him before. You get it.
You've been planning in the back of your mind, though.
You tell him, oh, darling, I'm going to work today. No, oh, baby.
I'm trying to drive you now.
Food is ready. I've been eating. Oh, you're going to work now, okay? Pick a taxi or an Okada and follow him.
Follow suit.
Or anywhere he's going.
Follow the office. Follow him.
When you're following them with anger, you will not get the result you want because you're angry. The both of you are angry. But when you calm down, you catch him when he did not.
Yes.
I didn't experiment. He did not experiment.
And when you catch achievement, like do it like a detective scene.
Yes.
Put all the pictures, the text, everything down. And when he can't say it's a lie, he can't deny it. But then I would say, like, don't jump into conclusions just like that. Investigate, or if you're not the extra type like us, because we would investigate. If you're not like us.
I'll wear my black and black.
Ah!
Inspector, you have no idea.
I'm in action. Boom, 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 boom. you get that thing.
You bar, come on. But if you're not like us, but you should be like us, Anna.
Please.
You should be like us. Like, if you're not like us, that's your problem.
You can apply me. You can apply me. I'll help you. It's just 5,000 CDs. That's all.
No, if you are not like us, you then just talk to him, have a conversation with him. But let me tell you, 90% of the time, he gonna lie.
They always lie.
Unless like your man is like correct and he really feels sorry. Maybe it's a one time thing, like a one time.
Yeah.
But one time, boy, you going, boy, bye. So the very next question, love what you're doing with your channel, by the way. Thank you, girl. She's young, beautiful, and energetic. Not the perfect body, but she's popping. She's ripe and all. You get what I mean? We get you, girl.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Suddenly she's single and all. And I mean, all her friends and folks are no longer single. They're all cuffed, trapped. Now she's feeling a bit weird about herself. What should she do? Because she's in the right mind to date. No one is moving to her. And all the ones that do are time wasters or not her taste. Everyone says she's amazing, but why is she single then?
Let me tell you, do you know the truth? You know this situation is like the worst and most tempting situation ever. Like it will push you, it will even make you date like the most available. Let me say, even if it's a masquerade that is in front of you, you'd want to date the person that time, not because you really love this person. But just because I want to belong, I want to, everybody's having a boyfriend, let me have my own. This is like the most tempting situation.
But you know, if you think about this, your girls are actually envious of you or your singleness. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of
because
people
you don't know what they're going through. Like when your time comes, you'll get what you want. Everybody should relax. Like,
it will come to you. Yeah,
like, you don't need to stress.
You don't need to stress.
You're beautiful.
Like, you're beautiful. You're energetic. You're perfect. Babe, like, enjoy.
What is yours is yours forever. Yes. God has created this thing. It is dear for you. Be calm.
Yeah,
like,
relax.
Cool down. Like, don't what are you rushing
like,
for?
If you want to party, do all your party. Do because if when it gets the time, the guy will start saying, "Oh, you party way too much.
Yeah, you party too much.
Oh, you do this way too much. Oh, your tummy is too big. Oh, you're too bro."
If nobody will call you and be like, "Hello, where are you? Why are you not in the hostel by this time? Why should you be out by this time? Oh, these are things you do in a relationship that I don't like. You see,
you're
free from all these things."
Just relax, your taste is coming, your man is coming. So this is the very last question. My friend got out of a relationship in August and she's still getting over the guy, right? But she's friends with this other guy who is really great. She's not ready for anything now and she doesn't know how to tell him. The thing is, the guy hasn't told her he likes her or anything, but he's dropping hints and stuff. So she can't just blurt anything out to him. You have to be patient and wait for him to tell you first.
Before you
say, because it will be such a diss if you misread and then you go and tell him, I know you like me, but like, don't, because I'm like,
you disgrace you. Even if he liked you.
Did I tell you I like you?
Bob,
you don't want that. You don't want that. I'll be
sure.
Like, chill.
Just be sure.
And you don't need to take advantage of the fact that you opened your mouth.
Like you can start telling other people that you will just.
If you really say, if you're honest to yourself that you don't like this guy, just
and
ignore the hint.
It's difficult.
Stop going close to him.
Yeah, withdraw yourself from him. You have to try. Reduce your.
Yeah, don't do it in a mean way though. Yeah. Just a little distance. Let him get So this is the end of the video, and please don't forget to like this video.
Subscribe.
Give it a thumbs up.
Subscribe.
Yes.
Subscribe. If you don't subscribe, we shoot you. Ha, ha. And the thing goes.
Ski.
Poop. Yeah, that's it.
You don't know.
Like I was saying, subscribe, comment down below, like this video. And please, if you guys want us to do another asking for a friend,
or want something different. You know,
yes. We could do that for you. We'll be there for you. And if you guys want us to add some guys to it, you know, so us with like some guys, please say that, and we would just put that down in the comment box, and we will do that for you. Like, we've got your backs all day and day.
Here.
Okay, bye. God bless you.
Bye.